Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to our assembly once again. Today it's part two of our assembly on feelings. I did the part one before half term, and I do hope you had a wonderful half term. The sun was shining, wasn't it? So you had some really good weather. I hope you were able to go to the park or in the garden at least and be outside and getting some nice sunshine. But now, here we are back again to do an assembly, and you'll see I've changed rooms. I decided I'd do this one in my living room because it's a bit brighter in here and I thought that was a bit nicer. So here we are to do our part two of our assembly on feelings. And if you remember, the last one was all about the film Inside Out, the Disney Pixar. And hopefully some of you got to see that over half term. We'll see. If you didn't, don't worry. We're still going to talk about feelings and about the next bit of that film. So who can remember what the feelings are in Riley's head in the film? Okay, shout them out. Yeah. Uh-huh. Fantastic. Oh, we've got them all. That is brilliant. So there is fear. There is envy. There is anger, sadness, and joy. She feels all those things. And we talked a little bit last time about how we feel all those things and that it's okay to feel them. What is important is what we do with them. So if we feel angry, if we feel afraid, or if we feel a bit envious about something, sad or even happy, we have to talk to somebody and tell them. Try and find the words and put it into words to be able to tell people how we feel. The other thing we talked a little bit, tiny little bit about in the last assembly was these. Can you tell me what they are? Fantastic, yes, they are memory balls, absolutely. And all of Riley's memories are collected, aren't they, in memory balls. But some of them are called core memories. And core memories are the memories that make her who she is. And so for you, it's the things that make you who you are. If I tell you what hers were, then maybe you can think about what core memories you have. So for Riley, there was the family. That was a core memory, all the things she's done with her family. Her friends, she had a friend's core memory. She had the things she liked to do, and for her that was hockey. But you might have something else. But it was things she liked to do was another memory. The fourth memory was fun, the thing she did that made her laugh, the thing she did that was a bit goofy sometimes, but was really fun. And the fifth one was the one that she always told the truth, didn't she? It was her honesty and telling the truth. And they were hers. So I wonder, do you want to tell me some of the things that you think are your core memories? What things make you who you are that you can remember? Fantastic, yes. Brilliant, yes. A lot of you saying family, mums, dads, grandmas, granddads. Absolutely right. Any others? Friends? Yes, yes. All right, dancing. So the fun things, or no, that would be the things you like, isn't it? The dancing. Football, yeah, got that. Reading, yeah, they're all the things you like to do, the things that keep you who you are. And what about some fun things? Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Great. There are lots of things there, aren't they, that make up those core memories, and we have to have them. But in the film, sadness touches the core memories, doesn't she? And they go blue. And that makes Riley really sad. And joy tries to get them back so that they can stop being sad. But as she tries to get them back, they have a little bit of a struggle with each other and they fall down the tube that takes them all the way to, that's absolutely right, to long-term memory. And that's where they end up. And the rest of the film is about how they get out of long-term memory. Because if they don't have sadness and joy, then all Riley's left with is fear, anger, and envy. And imagine having to live with just them. You wouldn't want to always be afraid or always angry, would you? No, nobody would. So we've got to get sadness and joy back, so that Riley becomes a whole person again. And that's what the film is about. But while they're there, they find another friend. And it was Riley's imaginary friend when she was a little girl. Anybody remember what he's called? Fantastic, yes, Bing Bong, absolutely. And Bing Bong's great. Now, what was Bing Bong made up of? Can you remember that bit? I'll tell you what, I'll put a photo up, might make it easier for those who haven't seen the film. Can you tell what he's made from? So here's the photograph. Right, see if you can tell me what he's made of. Yeah, he's made of cotton candy for his body, absolutely. He's made of, yeah, a cat for his whiskers and his tail. He has an elephant's trunk and ears. Oh, you're very good at this. And he's part dolphin, which is a part you can't see, but you can hear, because he makes the dolphin noise, doesn't he, and claps his hands together. Yeah. And there is another one, which isn't really what he is, but when he cries, what happens? He cries sweets, doesn't he? He cries sweeties. Absolutely. But he is amazing. So that's Bing Bong. That's who Bing Bong is. And Bing Bong tries to help Joy and Sadness, doesn't he? To get back into the control center in Riley's head so that they can all be together again. And he tries all sorts of ways. There's lots of adventures. You have to watch the film to see them. But there is one point where Joy and Bing Bong fall down a hole, don't they? They fall down a hole where memories are never found again and they can't get out. And then they remember something. They remember something, don't they? I'm going to give you a little clip of the film now so that you can watch it and you can see what happens. But it is a little bit sad, but it's wonderful. So let's watch that little clip now, shall we?
Hop in.
Come on, Joy, one more time. I got a feeling about this one. Take her to the moon for me, okay?
Well, wasn't that fantastic? And I did tell you it was a little bit sad because, of course, Bing Bong, he's not there anymore. But Bing Bong, the great thing, the wonderful thing is that Bing Bong gives his life to save Riley. That's the best friend you can have. So, who do we know that gave his life to save all of us? Right, absolutely right. Jesus did, didn't he? Jesus died on a cross and gave up his life to save us because he's our best friend too. So it's great to see that Bing Bong and Jesus were very much alike. That's why I like that film, because there's a real good message there, isn't there, about Jesus, and that is just fantastic. And Bing Bong helps Joy to get back, and Joy and Sadness find their way back to the control center so that all the feelings are reunited and Riley becomes a lovely little girl again. And we've got Jesus to help us with that, haven't we? So if we tell Jesus the things that are wrong, if we talk to Jesus, if we ask him to help us, he will. And he'll help us to be kind and caring and lovely, just like Riley. And that's what we have to do. So don't ever forget that. And we can ask Jesus to help us, can't we, by praying. And so we're going to say the prayer that we know, the Lord's Prayer. So let's say this together, shall we? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Amen indeed. Well, we're going to sing again. And we're going to sing the same one we sang in part one. I did tell you you'd get another chance at this. So you're going to sing this again, and it's called My Light House. So let's sing it, shall we?
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore.
My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you.
Oh, well, I do hope you enjoy. I love that, don't you? I just love it and all those actions that go with it. So I do hope you enjoyed that song. It was brilliant. Well, it's been good to share another assembly with you, and I hope that you'll come and share it the one next week. Not quite sure what I'm going to do next week. Maybe if you've got some ideas for assemblies, you could put them on South Crossland Twitter feed on the website, and then they can send them to me, and I can do some assemblies on some things that you would like an assembly on. Might be a story from the Bible, or it might just be about something that happens in life. Why not give me some ideas, and I'll see what I can do. All right. Bye for now. Have a good week. Bye.